Hello, travelers. Boardman 21 here, and today's build is a mix between the S tier end game Necromancer, cold minions, freeze minions, ice minions, whatever you want to call it, that uses the skeleton mages and the skeletons to deal huge amounts of cold damage and have 100% crit. And we're going to mix it with the interaction that Tunk found for his 1000 plus wave Necro Pusher that basically just used Dreadshade on a Golem that has so much taunt that everything on the map is gonna go for it. And basically, how this entire build works is you're gonna use the same DPS build as the Ice Necro, but now you're gonna throw in the Golem and take an extra point into Dreadshade to put taunt on that Golem so that everything will attack it and you never have to worry about being attacked. The only way to die in Arena is if all of your minions die. And that's almost impossible because with how much life you can stack and the fact there's only a 10-second cooldown on the Golem, you'll always be able to replace him to take the taunt again. Your other minions aren't going to die that much unless you put them too close to the Golem, but since when you push A, you can keep them away from the Golem, since the Golem is rooted, it won't be able to move and everything will be attacking it. So it makes it very easy to separate them out, very easy to put the taunt on the Golem, and then of course, because your minions are ranged, they attack from a distance, they're going to have dodge, they're going to have health, they're going to have health regen, so they're going to have high survivability. And again, this one has push, it's been proven the concept can go over 1,000 waves and just keep going if you really want to spend the time to push it. It can be rather boring as the minions, while they do great damage, once you get to 500 plus waves, it's going to slow down. It's going to take them a while to get their kills. And then, of course, you have a second taunt that you can do as well. If for some reason your Golem is dying so fast, just in a dot or whatever it's standing in, that you can't resummon him because the cooldown is too long, you can always throw Bone Prism as well, and that has taunt on it as well. You can also throw taunt on your other minions and sacrifice them for a little bit while you wait for the Golem to come back. The taunt will work on any of your minions, but it works best on the Golem. Alright, let's go ahead and get into the skills, the interactions, and just how this build works. Skills, I'm running Summon Bone Golem, Bone Curse, Dreadshade, Summon Skeleton Mage, and Summon Skeleton. For Summon Bone Golem, you can really build this tree any way that you want. Just make sure you get the extra health, the extra armor, and of course the extra taunt. That's going to help the most for it being able to taunt everything on the entire map. Of course, most of that work is done straight from Dreadshade. But here we got 5 points in Amalgam of Sentinels, 4 points in Tower of Bones, 4 points in Natural Speed, 5 points in Amalgam of Primalist, and 2 points in Hunger, which lets it gain 14 health when it does an attack and will replenish 14 of your health as well. For Bone Curse, the only thing I'm using Bone Curse for is to summon a Bone Prism. The only time you're going to need that is if for some reason your Bone Golem died quicker than 10 seconds and the cooldown is still on it so you can't redo it. You're really just not going to need it. You can respec Bone Curse to use any other skill you want, whether it be Transplant, Rip Blood, Abomination, really anything else that you want to run. You can throw that in there as well if you wanted. But here I have Bone Curse. We've got 5 points in Conflation, 1 point in Bone Prison, 5 points in Ossify, 1 point in Shattered Prison, 5 points in Defile Defenseless, 3 points in Marrow Thief. Now the one thing that will help with Bone Curse is since this build it does revolve a lot around the taunt so that you don't take damage, even though you are pretty tanky yourself as well, you can take a hit if you need to. What this does allow is if you're running Echoes, you can just throw Bone Curse out and not really taunt your minions as much, so that way you don't leave a Golem or leave one of your minions really far behind. Of course, if you do, once it wears off, they'll catch up to you pretty quick. They're pretty fast now with the new AI, the further back that they are. For Dreadshade, we have this setup, so it's almost the exact same as it is in the other builds, except now we're putting the one extra point in Deadlock so that it taunts enemies but roots your minion. The rest of our points, we have 3 in Lingering Doom, 1 in Pernicious Pact, 1 point in Egoism, 2 points in Spectral Presence, 3 points in Dying Coven, 3 points in Grim Fate, 1 point in Symbiotic Apparition, 3 points in Flesh Harvest, 1 point in Dread Plague, and then the 1 point in Mardi Doom, so you get that 25 flat armor per point of int that you have. Then for Summon Skeleton Mage, we got this set up so that we have as many mages as possible, so that we're only getting the Cryomancers, the ice mages, and then that they have extra projectiles and just doing as much damage as possible. So we got 5 points in Cellar Mortis, 3 points in Grey Merchant, 1 point in Order of Death, 4 points in Splinter Dominion, 5 points in Gravetide, 1 point in Cryomancers, and 1 point in Frost Lich. And then for Summon Skeletons, this is a little different than we have it set up in the Freezing Ice Minions. We're taking the cooldown inside of the tree now so that they can fire off their arrows more often. We've got 1 point in Sweeping Strikes, 2 points in Unbound Necromancy, 1 point in Grave Walkers, 3 points in Necrotic Conviction, 1 point in Hollow Walkers, 1 point in Bone Armor, 3 points in Impatient, so they have 90% increased cooldown recovery. Now, this is meant for Bone Armor, but it's actually global, so any attacks, any sort of ability that they have that has cooldown will be sped up. Then we got 3 points in Unholy Rage, 1 point in Marrow Walkers, 1 point in Lone Guardian, 1 point in Mightier Than the Sword, 1 point in Fire Arrow. What this does is this means they can fire an arrow every 3 seconds. Now, you can take a point out of Sweeping Strikes and then put that in Ice Arrow. This will convert it to ice, you know, cold and physical, which is what we're scaling. However, I didn't make that switch yet on my build. And then with 1 point in Multi-Shot, this increases the number of arrows as well as the cooldown. So there's a 7 second cooldown and they fire 3 arrows. With the 90% cooldown, it actually reduces it down under 4 seconds. So they're casting it almost twice as often with those extra projectiles, which really increases the AoE of the build. For passives, I've got 20 points in the base Acolyte class with 5 points in Bone Aura, 5 points in Blood Aura, 5 points in Stolen Vitality, and 5 points in Dark Rituals. Then I have 93 points in the Necromancer, which is the Mastered class, 8 points in Risen Army, 3 points in Cursed Blood, 7 points in Aegis Fall, so each one of your minions will almost apply 2 stacks of armor shred on every attack, and there is a massive amount of attacks, so lots of armor being shred. 8 points in Blood Armor, 5 points in Mortal Tether, 1 point in Unbound Necromancy, 8 points in Tyrant. Some people ask me why I'm putting the full 8 points into Tyrant. It is for that increased health. I know it reduces minions' health, but minion health isn't as important in this build. Us having more health is going to help us with, if we do take a hit, not dying. 2 points in Tyrant's Legion, 10 points in Moonlight Prior, 8 points in Rite of Undeath, 10 points in Blades of Forlorn, 1 point in Disciples of Necromancy, 5 points in Frantic Summons, 5 points in River of Bones, and 10 points in Hearsay. And then for idols, items, uniques, blessings, the idols are going to be the exact same as the other build. We're still going for the minion cold damage, we're still going for the increased health, flat health. If you want, you can also get minion critical strike chance, minion base crit chance. Any of those will work. For uniques, we are wearing the Reach of the Grave. This will increase the minion's spell and bow damage, as well as let them leech a bunch of that damage they do, and increase their attack and cast speed. We'll once again be wearing the Death Rattle. You can wear the Frozen Eyes of Foremost if you want. Here, I just wanted the minion critical strike multiplier, along with the Int, and of course, you don't really care that your minions are taking a little bit more damage. When they do die, you'll gain a little bit of health. They don't die very often. And then a +1 is Sacrifice, which doesn't really help you because you're not using Sacrifice. As for the crafted items, the main things, you want to get the base critical strike chance for your skeletons and skeleton mages on both the helm and the chest. You can get +1 maximum skeletons on the chest. You only need tier 1 of that. Even if you go all the way to tier 5, it's still only +1 maximum skeleton. So unless you get exalted and get tier 6 and tier 7, you're not going to get more than that +1 maximum skeleton. So don't worry about getting that to tier 5. Tier 1 is all you need. We're wearing the Carapace Shield just to cap out the poison resist right off the bat. We do a lot of standing around. You don't have to do that, but for me, it's more likely that I'll accidentally stand in poison because I get kind of complacent just standing there since everything is aggro to my golem. And then for everything else, I'm just going to hover over it really quick. Nothing really special. It'll all be in the build planner, which will be linked both below in the description, and it will be in the written guide. And then for blessings, nothing really fancy with the blessings. None of it's going to make or break the build. You can get your resistances here. You can get additional mana here. Your endurance. You can get additional armor here. The armor here is actually really beneficial to get flat and increased in your blessings because it will stack both with Dreadshade and, of course, all the flat armor you get from intelligence from that. For the character sheet, as you can see, we have just under 2400 health, which is a massive amount. It's a lot. It's going to keep you alive. We have capped resistances, everything except for 1% physical and 4% necrotic, which really isn't a big deal. If you get better rolls or more towards the higher end, above average rolls, you're going to cap these no problem. We got 30% armor. Remember, when I cast Dreadshade, especially, you know, as long as I stay within range of it, which you will kind of be in and out of, that armor will go up. You see, I have 30% without it. I jump to 48% as the golem's life goes down. That will go up. But you have quite a bit of armor on this build. Now, I'm not going to normally spend too much time inside of the circle because I'm not wanting to be around the golem. He is taking all of the aggros. He is going to get all of the AoEs at him. But if you're for some reason happen to be in the circle, at least since you're close to him and you might be taking more damage, you'll have additional armor as well. And then for damages, none of them matter. We're not doing any damage ourselves. It's all going to be minions. On the defense side of things, we have capped endurance, capped critical strike avoidance. Endurance threshold isn't the highest, but there's enough there so that if you do take a big hit, it's just going to keep you alive. For minion stats, we have just over 700% health. And then, of course, we don't have minion health regen anymore. It's flat minion health regen, but hopefully that gets updated soon so that it's reflected in here. We got 400 minion dodge rating. And then minion critical strike chance is at 13%. That, of course, does not have the base critical strike chance for your mages and your skellies. They are doing 100% for me. There's no doubt. I see no white dots damage. When we attack the training dummy here in a minute, you'll see everything's yellow. They have their 100% crit chance. And then for, unless the golem is attacking the golem, that's the only thing that'll be white numbers. The golem doesn't have that extra base, so it's not going to be as high for him. But again, he's usually not even attacking as he's just being attacked, especially from ranged characters. And then the minion critical strike multiplier is just over 400%, which is equivalent to what you could have gotten with a good max ruled death rattle before. Now when we get the multiple critical strike multiplier from both the death rattle and the two rings. And then of course they have that power because we are a level 100 character. They get that 40% boost of damage and 40% less damage taken. Alright, for the skill rotation and how to play the build, it's really as simple as you want to put Dreadshade on your golem, and that'll keep him in place. So once you place it on him, everyone else can go and attack. You can move them around if you want. You can notice right off the bat, they're just all doing their damage now, except for the ignites, the bleeds, whatever else they may be applying. That's the only white damages you're gonna see. Everything else is just crits form, and they're doing massive damage. Now, inside of Dreadshade, they will do more damage than outside. They'll also have that 45% boost to damage. So keeping a Dreadshade on your golem is priority, and then keeping your minions somewhat close, but maybe not too close so that they die, is going to really boost your damage to the max. Now again, since everything's attacking your golem, it really doesn't matter how long it takes to kill things, because as you can just go forever. So if you don't want the golem, you don't want your minions to die, you can keep them outside the circle. They'll do a little less damage, but they'll stay alive. They're not going to get hit by any of the AoEs or anything else that happens to be attacking your golem at the time. And then Bone Curse is the only thing that is really not used in the build. Like I said, you can trade it out with anything else. But if for some reason your golem is dying, you have that 10 second cooldown on it, you don't have enough mana to spam him, you can instead do a 13 mana cost Bone Curse, and it's going to give you taunt with all of these bad boys. You can also throw Dreadshade on your Bone Prism if you'd like to throw the taunt there instead of on the golem. But remember, when your Bone Prism expires, it's not based on life, it's on a timer, so it's going to disappear, and you got to be ready for that, anticipate that, and have a Dreadshade ready to go back on your golem. Alright, that's going to be it for this build guide. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope it's a nice mix, and really, it's just an arena build. It can be a boss build as well. It's, like I said, not any faster or slower than the previous version where you go through the echoes with the freezing ice minion or cold minion necromancer that I've made. But this one's going to allow you to push the arena basically as long as you want. So give it a try. Hope you enjoy it. As always, stay safe, travelers, and enjoy some gameplay.